I've been good. A lot of things have changed. Still making music, but also became a lawyer and kind of changed everything. A whole idea behind going into law was growing up the way I did, I felt kind of bullied by law, basically, by the powers that be. And so I decided that I wanted to be an advocate for other people growing up like me. And I began to think really critically about our culture and about relationships between us and infrastructure and government and other governments. And it's a very big part of who I am now. As a rapper, I didn't want to emphasize that I was a law student too much. I didn't want it to be like, oh, I'm the rapping lawyer. I didn't want it to be gimmicky, you know? I don't think I would have been able to be an independent rapper if I wasn't a law student at the same time, and vice versa. They very much complemented one another inside me, you know? I've always been a goal-driven person, and I've always been a really hard worker. But I don't think I ever tested myself to the full limitations until I had to do both of these things simultaneously. And now that I'm looking back on it, I'm like, dude, that was a really rough time. When none of us could hold the gate. People are hiring me for my mind. I realized I had a responsibility to keep up with current events and to keep my mind really sharp. So the area of law that I love very, very much is immigration. Do immigration law right now, and I want to get into MCRIM, immigration criminal law, because a lot of our people that come here are labeled criminals, and it jeopardizes their ability to stay in the country. So, you know, that's part of law that I really love and I'm really committed to. Call me a goddess, a devil, I'm modern and I'm modest, I'm evil, but I'm honest, and whatever you've been saying, I've been that. Even a couple times or more, been war and I've been peace, and I've been a piece of a man's heart before, and a broken heart's too fell apart. Yoga is a huge part of my life. That's a huge influence. You know, after leaving law school, doing two albums back to back, as a lawyer, as a rapper, you're like, me, look at me, focus on me. I run this album, I run this thing, you know, like, it's very me-centric, and I think I needed yoga to understand how I work in the world. It was outer space. Never knew nothing, didn't know no one could have recognized my face. And they told me God and values, my future written down, and it seemed odd. And calloused, was torn apart, invalid. Introduced the bitter pill. I took, I sipped, I smoked, I looked, I shook the mold, I took, and I got free in prison, jail, got my degree, excelled. I used to write very personal poetry, very vulnerable, very honest poetry. And I don't know why I would never let that hit wax, you know? And after really, really allowing myself to be vulnerable through yoga, I wrote Sugar Water, and that was like a very personal album, and it felt very fulfilling. It's different. Keep me in your mind, but I'm distant. Sorry to divide your persistence. Nothing I would like better. When you're a first generation immigrant and you come to America, your family tells you all kinds of things about the Philippines, and they'll tell you things like, if you're bad, I'll send you to the Philippines, or look at America, look at all the things you have, you could never have this stuff in the Philippines. This idea that America was better than the Philippines, you know, and it hurts me to say that right now because that's such an imperialist way to think, but that's how I felt that when I got there, it was already set up. Like, I'm thinking I'm a be Hopie. I'm gonna bring my Hopies to the Philippines. No, they already have their own Hopies. They already have their own hip hop infrastructure. Hip hop is huge in the Philippines. They have an awesome art scene. I did like a radio interview. I did a magazine interview. I did a show at this place called B-Side. B-Side is this like giant building with like graffiti on the walls.
B-Side, magingayo.
I went from, let me tell you where I'm coming from, to I want to hear more about where you guys are coming from. This is crazy. This is my culture. You know what I mean? If I just stayed in this on this island, we would all have been rapping about the same thing. Yeah. So, you know, it was a very big deal going home the first time. What's really dope about this book is that it's the contributing writers are all hip-hop practitioners. So there's some rappers, some DJs, some graph artists, and they all wrote like chapters in this book, including myself. And it's all about Filipinos in America, Filipino hip-hop representation in America, which is groundbreaking to me because most people don't think of Filipinos when they think of hip-hop, but there is a lot of contribution that we had to the culture. Being part of this book, going to the Philippines, being part of a community of hip-hop artists who are Filipino, who happen to be Filipino, it feels really good. What do I hope for in the future? I hope for police accountability. Related to that is an end to police brutality. I hope that people learn their rights and learn how to assert them instead of being confused about what's happening. I want people to be more proactive. I want my family to be good, and I want the music to be good, and I want to be really, really smart. I really want to be a really talented lawyer. Mm-hmm. And get that case, the one that makes me feel like I'm Aaron Brockovich this motherfucker, you know what I mean? Something like that. More than what I bargained for, but never off the table. Don't know, but know what really drives me or what I am made of. So meet me, come see me, come peek inside discreetly. Walk deep into my vision till you honestly can feel me. Don't spill me, my cup it runneth over. In love on every plane, and then I'll grave it in the Midas touch, engrave it in my name. Every word I speak, tattoo it in your heart and on your lips, hoping it forever on your mind and at your fingertips. And it's a welcome.